A Mr. Betty Krueger video or film?
The cigarette fell to the floor. Slowly it ignited the gas, and suddenly a hungry roaring flame swept towards Mr. Melrose. The heat smashed into him, singeing him. He was surrounded by burning fire. His clothes and hair began to burn as he screamed, and the metal megaphone began to blister his skin. His screams ran out, he inhaled, and the flames flew down into his lungs, scorching them too. There was a hot sweat down the middle of his back when he woke, slumped in the armchair. It was getting dark. He had wasted most of the evening. He got up and put the living room light on, then looked at the carriage clock on the mantelpiece. It was gone 7 p.m. He had to prepare something to eat, yet another late meal. But first he tried to tidy up a bit, stacking up magazines and books, putting candy wrappers in the trash, and toys in a pile. But it was hopeless, and the room didn't look much better when he had finished. Everything he had moved just revealed a stain, or dirt, or a tear. Little reminders of how incapable he was. He couldn't cook, he couldn't clean, he couldn't do DIY, or paperwork, or finances. And what was worse, he couldn't afford to pay someone else to do those things. "Sammy!" he yelled up the staircase.
"What?"
"Come down here a minute." Mr. Melrose looked through the contents of the freezer as Sammy clumped his way into the kitchen.
"What's for dinner then, Dad?"
"Turkey drumsticks and chips."
"No, we had them last night."
"We didn't, did we? I don't remember." Sammy snickered. Daddy was often forgetful. What about pizza?"
"No, I don't want that. Yuck."
"Well, what do you want then?"
"Alpha bites and beans."
Mr. Melrose looked through the various boxes in the freezer. His hands were getting cold. He knew there were beans in the cupboard, but alpha bites. He couldn't see any. "How about waffles instead?"
"No, alpha bites."
"But we haven't got any."
"Alpha bites and beans, I want them."
"Oh, hell, come on, Sammy, don't mess me around. We haven't got any. We've got loads of other stuff, though. What about sausage rolls?"
"Alpha bites!"
There was a bang as Mr. Melrose slammed the freezer door, which made Sammy jump. Daddy was angry. "Right. Alpha bites it is, then. I'll go out and buy some from the supermarket. It's not like I haven't got anything better to do with my time." And he grabbed his wallet. "Or like I haven't got much money to spare. Oh no, you'll have alpha bites." And the front door slammed.
"Goody! Alpha bites!"
Sammy danced around the kitchen, then got a Mars and Twix from the fun-size bag of chocolates in the cupboard and ate them. They left melted chocolate on his fingers, which then smeared on the paintwork. So he wiped his hands clean on the white hand towel, which left brown stains on that as well. He then went and played with his toy cars in the living room, bashing them into each other and the skirting board, picturing crashes and hideous deaths in his head.
"Go on, eat them all."
"I'm not hungry anymore."
"But you've only eaten a few of them."
"You have them."
Sammy pushed his plate towards his father, who shoved it back.
"I'm not eating your mauled food. You asked for them, you can bloody well eat them."
"Don't swear, it's bad."
Sammy started prodding reconstituted potato shapes around his plate with his fingers, obviously having no intention of eating the rest of his meal. His father couldn't take much more.
"No, you're the bad one. I do everything for you, Sammy, and you never appreciate it. It's never enough. Why, huh?"
Mr. Melrose could hear his voice wavering, changing pitch, getting emotional. Every last shred of his patience and strength was being stretched to snapping point.
I just want sweeties now, but you won't let me!
Sammy's bottom lip suddenly curled, and he began to cry.
I want sweeties, and I want my money back! It's not fair!
His father was surprised, then relented and leaned over and went to hold Sammy. He felt like crying, too.
I know it's not fair. Life isn't. I want your mom back, too.
But Sammy jerked back at the touch, his eyes flashing, and he looked fiercely at Mr. Monroe's.
Don't touch me! I want my mommy, not you! And I want a chocolate bar!
Shock passed. Then Mr. Melrose yelled,
You can't have your mommy! You can't have everything you want! No one can! You ungrateful little bastard! Now get up to your bed now!
Sammy scuttled off up the steep, dark stairs, muttering he didn't bother to brush his teeth. He preferred it when they felt rough. Instead, he kicked his action man around his bedroom for a bit, imagining his screams as the giant bashed him. Then he put on his Winnie the Pooh pajamas and got into the bed. He put the lamp out and went under the covers to play with his glow-in-the-dark skeleton. Meanwhile, downstairs, Mr. Melrose was crying. He had his head resting on his forearms and sobbed quietly. He needed fresh air. He needed to get away from the house for a bit. More importantly, he needed to get away from Sammy. He decided he would go for a walk. He would go to the cemetery and crouch by certain graves, by Catherine's grave, for a while. Then he might find peace, even if it was only fleeting, even if it was but a breath of wind to cool him for a second. It would help him to carry on. He put his coat on, and he went outside into the neon-lit night. Sammy heard the front door close and realized that Daddy had gone out.
Ha! Now I'm gonna get it!
He muttered, thinking of the chocolate that would soon be his. He usually had some sweets hidden under his pillow, but there were just empty wrappers tonight. So the idea of another bar of chocolate was even more comforting. He turned his attention back to his grinning, glowing skeleton. He wished he could glow like that. Maybe his daddy would buy him some glow paint sometime. He would ask him tomorrow. A few minutes passed while he imagined being able to scare people at school by glowing at them in the dark book cupboard. Then he heard the front door close quietly. He hadn't heard the usual rattle when it opened. Just the quiet click. As the catch fell back into place, Sammy lifted up the corner of his quilt, letting the cool draft from the dark room, and listened. He wanted to know if Daddy had his chocolate, though surely there hadn't been enough time for Daddy to go on to the garage already. So Sammy was a bit confused. He couldn't hear anything else, so he snuck over to his bedroom door and pulled it ajar to listen more carefully. The landing and the staircase was dark as he had left it, but most of the downstairs lights seemed to be switched off as well. Even as he stood there, he heard a click from the kitchen, and the house was plunged into complete blackness. Daddy had turned out the kitchen light too. Why? Then Sammy remembered that Daddy sometimes did that when he was sad and sat in the dark. Silly Daddy. Something moved in the kitchen. It sounded like a drawer being opened and closed. Maybe Daddy had forgotten his wallet and he had come back for it. Sammy strained to listen but heard nothing else for a whole minute. Then the living room door creaked open. Daddy was moving awfully quiet in the dark. Maybe he thought Sammy was asleep. Daddy would now either go back to the front door or come up to the stairs. Sammy hoped he would come upstairs and give him some chocolate and say sorry for shouting like he did sometimes. A stair creaked. He was coming upstairs. Sammy rushed over to his bed and climbed inside, then pulled the quilt up over his head again. He would pretend to be asleep, and Daddy would decide not to disturb him. Then Sammy would say, "Boo!" And Daddy would laugh and give him chocolate. The stairs creaked again higher, and there was another noise too. Quite quiet. A sort of snipping noise. It was eerie. Every few seconds, there would be a creak or a noise like a big pair of scissors cutting the air. Sammy's imagination began to conjure up images he didn't want to see. Not at the moment. Daddy was being quiet. But why were there funny noises? It was like he was so eager about something that he couldn't help being excited and giving himself away. And that was why there was funny noises every 10 seconds or so. Snip. The noise was near the top of the stairs. Then the house went quiet again. Snip. That noise was quieter, more stealthy, and seemed to come from just outside the bedroom door. Sammy wished he had closed it properly. He wished Daddy just go to bed. He didn't want the chocolate anymore. He heard the bedroom door creak slightly, almost inaudibly. He didn't have the courage to peep out from under the covers, so he huddled up to his grinning toy skeleton. He didn't feel like saying boo anymore either. Snip! The noise was by his bed in the dark, and it sounded more like a big pair of scissors than ever now.
Daddy!
Sammy's voice almost whispered, terrified, from under the covers. Only Sammy didn't think it was Daddy anymore.